Visibility? We don't need no stinking visibility. Welcome to the Superpilotish channel. My name's Graham Wilson, and I'm going to be talking about instrument flying. I'm going to talk about instrument flying. And I can't see anything right now. Why? Because I have a view limiting device on. Okay, let's take it off. And you'll get to see the big shine off my forehead here. Whoa. Don't adjust your sets. That's actual balding. Anyways, time to put the old... That's the reason I have this hat in the first place, is because the big old growing foreheads keeping growing and making the lighting all off. Okay, here we go. Let's adjust some stuff here. And so we're going to be talking about... Oh, and then you see this cool thing here. I got banners. We got pinned comments. We're doing all kinds of cool stuff here on the Superpilotish channel. And I'm going to see if I can get rid of that banner too. Boom. Hey, cool. All right, guys. Well, yeah, so we're talking about instrument flying today because... Well, I'm going to be flying this afternoon, so my students got to do a little bit of that stuff. And I don't think I've ever done any show on that before. And it's one of the things that pretty much all the pilots out there, you know, if they're flying airliners and stuff like that, a lot of times, you know, you're sitting in the back and you're coming in to land or something and you're going through the cloud and you look out there and you can't see anything and you're like, how did the pilots know what they're doing? Well, they've been trained to do that type of thing. And hello, April and Gafook and Al. The pilots, we train for that type of thing. Now, I'm not a real expert on flying, just looking at those little dials and doodads and gadgets and stuff. That's the official pilot name for them, by the way. But it's like, I mean, I do have an instrument rating and I've had it renewed a few times. So... there we go. Hey, Wrench. And so I basically, when I'm teaching people instrument stuff, it's like I keep it to the very basics. Even the very lowest level of pilot training requires the student to learn, how do you fly if for some reason you go into a cloud by mistake? Or maybe I've had it where flying around where it's a beautiful, nice sunny day, but it's so hazy out over the lake that like you can't see really the ground and stuff like that. It's kind of all gray and weird, especially if flying at night. It still might be a nice starry night, but or it might not be a starry night. It might be kind of an overcast night where just everything just looks kind of black. And then, okay, try flying with your eyes closed. Whoa. So that won't quite work. And, hey, Dan. So I'm going to give you a little, just a little basic instrument flying thing here. Oh, and then for the actual pilots out there, I'm going to give you, I was doing some looking around on the YouTubes and the Googles, and there was this little way of looking at flight instruments that I couldn't really find a video on, so I figured I'd do one on it. Okay, so now we're going to make our cockpit. Okay, most of the time when, I guess it would be, there's different instruments that fly around. Like this is called the six pack, and most airplanes made, I will say, I don't know, like big jets and stuff like that. They kind of have a, they call it a glass cockpit. It's basically just kind of a computer screen that has one screen that has all your main information on it. Then they have another screen that's got your maps and weather and stuff like that. But usually when you're learning how to fly, you'll fly in a plane that's not brand new, not top of the line, not full autopilot, everything. It's just going to be some little Cessna or something, and you'll have some six pack gauges there. So they kind of went to a standard design before, I don't know, early 70s and stuff like that. Like they used to just kind of throw gauges all over the place. Oh, we'll stick an airspeed indicator over here, and so put a tachometer over here. And it was kind of all over the place. And it's really cool if you ever look at like a MiG-21 or like these Russian cockpit images, Google images and stuff like that. Man, there's just, it makes no sense. They just got everything all over the place. But generally, you try to organize all your instruments, our great engineers, and I'll set us up with a six pack, and we'll call this one the, okay, I'll label all these guys here, and I'll tell you what they do. Usually it's set up like this. So this is your airspeed indicator, attitude indicator, or that's your artificial horizon you've seen. Altimeter tells you how high you are above sea level. Your turn coordinator, so that's a thing. It's got a little ball in here too. Little ball, that'll keep you coordinated. And okay, and then your heading indicator, some people call that a directional gyro or a DG. And our vertical speed indicator, which tells you how fast you're going up and down. So, this one here, it's important to know that actually lags a little bit. It takes a little time. A lot of these other ones, they react when the airplane reacts right away. So that's kind of interesting to know, especially if you're required to fly at a specific vertical speed. You might make some adjustment in the plane, and nothing happens on this little guy here, but you'll notice the changes here. Anyways, okay, so here we go. We got this little stuff. And so usually if you're flying around, say you're flying straight and level in your good old, I just happen to have my training aid here, the KD-12X with added flaps. So if you're just flying straight and level, pretty easy peasy. You keep your wings level and don't pitch the nose up and down. So you don't go like that. 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 Just keep the wings level, keep the nose level, and away you go. So that's straight and level flight. And then so the pilots, the way I teach it to my students is if you're flying, you're kind of looking, there's a T-scan that you can do. But I'm going to talk to you about the pitch bank power scan. So there's other scans. Some people are looking in specific ways. I've seen you can even do like some kind of little go around in a square, a rectangle kind of scan. But what they mean is that that's another thing, too. I got to emphasize if you are going to be learning how to fly, even at like a private pilot level, knowing getting into the habit right away of doing a specific pattern to what you're looking at, that will do you like it's imprinting in on your brain. So if you ever go on to do some instrument flying on your own or do it for a job, or you're flying for some cargo company and some old clapped out piece of junk with one of these things still, you're going to be nice and safe flying through the clouds or when visibility is not so great. So, and I really wish that somebody would have emphasized to me how important to get a scan right away in your flight training, how important that is to get that habit going and specifically what to do. And a lot of times they just say, I knew one guy, he works at an airline now. When he was flying, I'm like, dude, do you do a scan or anything like that? We were learning how to fly at the same time. He's like, I just kind of look around. I'm like, well, that works for him. It's like, no, I was horrible at instrument flying when I started off. So because no instructor ever told me like, hey, this is important. Do it like this. Ding, ding, ding. So there's multiple ways of doing it. The pitch bank power scan is so, and that works on every single airplane. So that's one of the things, like some people call it a T scan, where you're scanning these instruments primarily, and every once in a while you check out that guy or that guy. But what if your instruments, you got some old plane and they're all over the place, or maybe you have a glass cockpit and it's just some screen, you know, like T, there's no T here. Although, speaking of T, on my Twitter page, I subscribed to Mr. T on Twitter, and he was doing some cool thing. He went back to his old neighborhood, or he's hanging out with schools and kids like he always does. And Mr. T actually replied to one of my, I said, great job, T, with like a thumbs up. And Mr. T actually liked my reply. So that was pretty cool, man. Mr. T's awesome. So anyways, the T scan's okay if it works. The Mr. T scan works just fine if you got your six pack, but if you don't, you're out of luck. So Pitch bank power. No matter what you do in your airplane, there's going to be some kind of instrument somewhere that's monitoring how's your pitch going. So pitch is when the nose of the airplane goes up or the nose goes down or it just kind of hangs around flat and you're not going up and down. So if you are going to be if you're going to be flying along level and you pitch up like this, well, it's going to start climbing up right away, right? So that would be your altitude would be off. So if your altitude's not doing anything, like you're, you know, just a little bit of movement, you're up another 10 feet, and that's going to register over here. So you would say pitch. Okay, I'll put a little PI. Okay, so pitch, that's your instrument for your pitch. And then your bank, okay, you would have your heading indicator. As soon as your bank is off, your bank in the wings, you know, you always see the planes go ripping around. There you go, they're banking. So your heading indicator would be the next one there. There's your bank. And then your power, which one would that be? It'd be pitch, bank, power. Is that right? Yeah. All right. Yeah. So if you're keeping the same pitch and you keep the same bank to go straight, if you mess around with your throttle, your airspeed is going to go up or down. So you just say, okay, which, what would affect my pitch? Move the plane's nose up and down. Oh, okay. This thing's moving. What would affect my bank? Bank it back and forth. Oh yeah, that's right. My heading indicator's moving here. And then if I keep that and that the same, what happens if I fool around with the throttle? That'll change your airspeed. So pitch, bank, power. So in straight and level flight, those are your main instruments. And you look at them, you tell yourself, okay, pitch, take a look. Hey, how's it doing? That's another thing with when people are scanning instruments, you don't want to scan too fast because you want your brain to be able to see if there's any changes going on or just take into the information and not just get in the habit. Eventually you will be able to kind of do it pretty quick. But at first you take a look at it in a couple seconds. Okay. Altitude. Yeah. Looking cool. Pitch, bank, heading indicator's not doing too much. Power. Oh, you know, I'm about 5 knots slower than what I want to be. I'll bump the power up a little bit. Oh, what happened there? Oh, that made me climb a little bit. So let's adjust that, maybe trim out my plane and go pitch, bank, power, pitch, bank, power. And you can do that for every phase of flight. If you are going to be climbing, okay, where's my little, my fancy eraser here? Okay, so anyways, I guess, I don't know. I kind of don't want to bore you guys, but... well, some pilots out there might find this kind of interesting. Okay, so that would be if you're straight and level. Next thing would be, let's just say you're climbing. You take off and climbing and whoop, popped into the clouds. Can't see what I'm doing. And all right. Oh, hey, Harold and Dan. And oh, Adam's here too. V-scan. There is one way of doing V-scans here and there if it's set up like this. So. Yeah, so say we're going to be climbing. All right, so pitch. If you're climbing up, and let's just say you got like full throttle, climbing up. Now, if you mess around with the pitch, your airspeed is going to change because, like, say you got lots of power coming, and then we got lots of power on there. All right, now if you go straighten out, you're going to be speeding up. If you pitch up like this, you're probably going to slow down, right? So your airspeed would be off on that one. So there's your pitch. Pitch. Now something to do with bank. Same as before with your heading indicator. Bank. And power. What would affect your power? Is the power pitch, bank? That's the secret one over here. That's where you're looking at your tachometer, or you might have a manifold pressure gauge or something like that. And yeah, so you'd be pitch, bank, and then your power's over here. Trick question. So yeah, you do that. Or you'd be saying, is that the desired power that I want? Sometimes you don't climb exactly at full power. You might have some kind of sustained climb power, 25 squared, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, so pitch, bank, power. And go, and then there you go. Your altimeter, that'll be changing because you're climbing. And the same thing works with descent. So there you go. Pitch, bank, power. It's easy peasy. It works on absolutely any setup. So you could change the placing of all of these gauges. And as long as you say, okay, I'm in a new airplane, it's like pitch is here, bank is here, power is there, and pitch, bank, power. And you tell that to yourself over and over again. You might even want to point at the instruments with your finger, pitch, bank, power, and then take in the information that you need. And every once in a while, check the other stuff. Make sure you don't run out of gas. That's handy. So, yeah, so that was just like a quick little pitch, bank, power scan thing that, and that would work on your glass cockpit too. If you've ever seen the glass cockpit, it looks like this. And you might have like a horizon in here, and you got some little bars on the side, but you can still say pitch, okay, I'm checking out my little guy here, you know, pitch, bank, power, whatever airspeed thing. Oh, another thing there too is that because that doesn't rely on the attitude indicator, it also works if you have a failure of the attitude indicator. So partial panel, you are cool with pitch, bank, power. Works for everything. It's only three things to remember, too. Pitch, bank, power. What's changing where? And I don't know. Did I tell you guys about my view limiting device here? That's what I forget. I think I told you right at the beginning. That's what you wear. So the student wears that so that they can't see outside, but they can see the instruments down here. Okay. View limiting device. Or people call that the hood, too. In the old days, they used to have, when they had a hood, who was it, Jimmy Doolittle, when he invented instrument flying, basically, they called it a hood. They put you like right underneath this hood of canvas or whatever, and you can only see the instruments, nothing outside. Another thing they did too, they put like this weird amber stuff on the screen. I heard about it. I've never seen it. And you wear some glasses and it kind of works like, what do you call that with your like polarized glasses? If they cross like this, they kind of black out. And so anyways, they did something like that with amber. I forget what that was. And here we go. Let's see here. Yeah, so Wrench is talking about here. He spray painted some safety glasses into foggles. Yeah, the other thing that you can do, some other people, they like their view limiting device to be not as clunky as this one, but they're really expensive. Like if you get some, you can get these ones that they kind of flip up and flip down, and they have little, just kind of little, I'll draw it for you. So you got your cool looking shades. This looks like Bo Diddley shades or something like that. I don't know. Okay, that's supposed to be like some shades that are going over your glasses. Then here in the right in the corners here, you can kind of see this will be all blacked out, and then you can only see right here in the middle. So that's what the foggles kind of look like. That's a, I think that's an actual brand name, foggles, and that works too for a view limiting device. They're not as clunky as that big thing, but okay, so we got that. That's another thing too. I'm kind of anally retentive about. I always got to make sure that my whiteboard is clean so it doesn't do any ghosting on there. And I don't know. And also, when you're teaching ground school as an instructor, if there's stuff left up on the whiteboard behind you, the students are looking at the whiteboard and they're not paying attention to you. So you always got to wipe it out. But okay, here we go. Do-do-do-do. All right. And what else we got here? Oh, Gray OG, I missed you. Has to run. Okay, you have a great weekend too, Gray OG, if you watch this again. And all right. And Al makes a very good point here that B.A. Baracus had to be sedated for flight. Yeah, B.A. Baracus, he was not the greatest flyer. I wonder how Mr. T is as a flyer in real life. He's probably tough. He could probably handle it. I wonder if they make him like pay extra for all those gold chains he wears or something like that. Like, I'm not putting this in my luggage. That'll cost too much. I'll just wear my gold chains. So there we go. Cool. Yep. So that's about it. Just a little, a little scan here kind of thing for any instrument pilots that maybe you haven't heard about that. And then I'm going to do a little post-production after this. Today's Friday, pizza night. Awesome. And I'm actually, you can tell by the watch, wearing the old pilot's watch. So I'm going to be going flying after this too and then start my weekend. So very cool. I don't really see any other big questions around there. So today's Friday, so I'll be back on Monday because I do this. Oh, Adam's asking a question here. There's a bit of a lag here between when people post here. So where's the pizza coming from? I'm gonna be getting my pizza from Sarducci's today. That's my favorite here in town. It's your standard Windsor pizza, and it's the best bang for your buck. It's nice and cheap, pretty close to where I live. Sarducci's, and they have a west and east location. So, and here we go. And yes, Dan, I will definitely enjoy the pizza. Okay, cool. What do we got here? We got more comments here that are interesting. I'm gonna hang out. Jake the Snake used to take a drugged snake as a commercial carry-on. I didn't know that. Jake the Snake. Yeah, man, that was pretty cool. What do we got here? Okay, one gratuitous bad dad joke pun here. I tried instrument flying. My trombone has better aerodynamics than my sousaphone. Wah, wah. Okay, you still get credit for that one, though, Gafook. And, yeah, okay. Yeah, I don't know. Thanks for the well wishes there, Adam. ADF on Monday. Does Lum have an ADF? I don't know. Anyway, send me an email or something like that. We'll see. I might be going flying on Monday too again, depending on the weather. So that's about it. So I'll be back on Monday because I do this Monday, Wednesday, Friday at noon Eastern. And we'll just kind of shut her down. And you guys have a fantastic weekend. So thank you for watching. Bye.